Hi there, and thanks for joining me to another programming tutorial on a SwiftUI topic. As you know, the TabView is one of the most important container views in SwiftUI. It allows to present content in tabs and pages. Important improvements were announced about it in WWDC 2024, with the most significant one being a view called Tab. Tab comes to provide an organized way to create tabs, and it replaces the tab item view modifier. Through its different initializers, it allows to set tag values, so it replaces the use of the tag modifier too. However, the new Tab API requires iOS 18 as the minimum system version, and there is no backwards compatibility. For older systems, we need to stick to the old APIs, but we'll see a few more details about that in a few moments. In this video, I'm going to demonstrate two things: how to create tabs in a tab view using Tab, and how to make it possible to select tabs programmatically. There are, of course, more advancements made available to TabView, but we'll talk about them another time in order to keep this video short. So let's get started with a familiar TabView that contains three inner views, resulting to three different tabs as you can see on the canvas. For simplicity, these views are text views. In the current implementation, I'm using the TabItemView modifier applied on each text view, and that's where the title and the image of each tab is set. Before I replace all this with a new tab, I'd like to start by saying that the tab item has been deprecated in iOS 18.2, so you should keep it in your code for as long as you are supporting iOS 17 and lower versions. As of iOS 18, you'd better use the new view called tab, so let's get to that. There are various initializers to use with tab, but the one you will mostly use is the one that accepts a title, a system image, and the content view. The logic is totally different here, as both label details and the contain view are all given as arguments. Next, let's provide the missing arguments to the tab initializer, with the proper title, system image name, and the contain view. In a similar way, I'm going to add two more tabs and achieve the same final result as before. The code is less and definitely looks more tidy with tab. You will see that once again right now, as we will make it possible to change tabs programmatically. Three steps are needed to manage that. The first is to declare a state property in the view, which will store the current tab index. So let's go right before the body opening, and let's add the selected tab property. It'll be giving int values, and there is really no reason to indicate tab index values with a different data type. The default tab will be the first one with a zero index. But the index of each tab is something that we have to manually define. Before we get there, let's proceed to the second step, which is to initialize the tab view with the selection parameter. The argument is the binding value of the selected tab, as the tab view will update it every time a tab is manually selected. Let's move to the third and last step in the process. We need to tag each tab with index values, and for that, we'll use a different initializer of the tab, the one that has the value parameter. The actual value we pass here is the desired index of each tab. Instead of defining all tabs from the beginning, we'll just update this we have over here, simply by adding the value parameter and fitting them with the tag value of each tab. Now let's add a button to the first tab that will let us open the third tab by tapping on it. Notice that when I'm clicking on it on the canvas, the selected tab gets the new value, and the settings tab is opening instantly. So that's the new tab in SwiftUI, which allows us to define tabs and set their content simply by using the proper initializer. I hope you've enjoyed this content and you've learned something new. If so, don't forget to share and also like and subscribe to my channel. That would mean a lot to me. Thank you for watching and enjoy coding.